The group was reportedly lured here with promises of an education at Lambert's Academy, which offers training in hospitality, along with promises of job placement. The owner of one of the guest houses where the group has been staying accompanied the group this morning, equally anxious to see the matter come to a satisfactory conclusion.
They are young guys, 21, and the oldest among them is 29. We have couples who gave up everything, and this morning, whilst we was waiting for everybody to gather, we have a couple on the internet talking to their 10-year-old and their 7-year-old son, which they left with family. And even though there's a language barrier, but there was one particular way that child talked, I knew the question he was asking: when are you coming back home?
Some of the group was reportedly questioned by police over the weekend. The alleged victims of the scam say they want their monies back, or at the very least for the government to assist them in obtaining the training they came here to get. Mrs. Odeh, who has become a bit of an advocate for the stranded strangers, wants a happy ending to their ordeal.
I want them to get their full package. Right now I want, harm has been done, damage has been done, but let us get a happy ending to this sorry story and put St. Lucia back in the good light. They paid for a diploma certificate, at the end of it, a job on a cruise line, give it to them and put St. Lucia back in the correct position.
Some of the group has reportedly paid in excess of $13,000 to get here. Originally, a group of 26 was supposed to have come across, but only 16 made it. The additional 10 were stopped at the border. This morning's meeting did not end with any definitive decisions by the Ministry of External Affairs, and the stranded group was simply told that the government would get back to them. For the DBS News World, Kendal Burton reporting.